So my specialty is actually in teaching nutrition to get results and actually get progress. So all of the people who come to the fitness center or the wellness program or the athletic training program or the chiropractor's office, and they work with the athletic person who does the sort of the physical therapy. You know, all of those people, they're going to need to get two things: results, and they're going to have to make progress. Now, so I think that is really the nuts and bolts of what I'm going to go into with nutrition, because nutrition is kind of what, to me, it's we've got three pillars. We've got the first pillar of what you eat, the nutrition piece. The second pillar of what you do, the exercise piece, whatever that means, the physical, you know, realigning. And then we've got what you think. And I don't think in the textbooks they talk enough about the power of the mind. And that's a huge part of what I do with clients and what I've done throughout my entire career to help people. So I'm going to talk about a few case studies, because the way that I learned how to be a successful professional was through case studies and role playing. And we're going to do a little bit of that today. So first case study we're going to talk about, and this is kind of one of my superstar clients. I'll pass this around, and then I'll talk about it. So I'm going to just pass this guy around. So this guy is Chuck Grenner. He's on the back of, I wrote a couple of books. He's on the back of the Food Log and Nutrition Journal, because Chuck Grenner lost 200 pounds in a year and a half. Now, that's kind of TV worthy. He's not been on TV. But he did 100 pounds in 8 months and 5 days. And I saw the man once a week. And so how did somebody make that much progress that much, that fast? This is not the biggest loser, not at all. But I will tell you, the number one thing he did is he kept food log. He wrote down every bite of everything he ate. So nutrition, you know, when you see your person who comes in and says, hey, I want to lose 40 pounds. I want to lose 100 pounds. I'm carrying an extra 200 pounds. I just want to get, I'll feel good when I get 50 off. It is nutrition, 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 nutrition. And I'm a personal trainer telling you, they could lose all the weight without exercise. Correct, Taryn?
Sure.
They could. Now, you may have that person, a herniated disc in the back or two. Maybe they've had a broken foot. Maybe they've had a car accident and they've got to lose 40 pounds. It can be done in a healthy way when they can't exercise. Sometimes you got what you got and you got to work with somebody. So Chuck came in to me. He was a referral from another client. And this other client had actually lost 60 pounds and they were in a networking meeting together. And he leaned forward and said, tell me what you've done, to his friend. So I met Chuck and he comes in. He's like this. I mean, he's, you know, 430 some pounds. I mean, he's a big guy. And he sits down, he says, you know, I had an accident about 10 years ago. I had an injury to my heel. I had some surgery. I got depressed. He owns a business. Business was tough around 2010. And so the weight just kept coming. You know, nobody thinks they're going to gain 20 pounds. And they certainly don't think they're going to gain 100 pounds. And nobody thinks that that weight is going to snowball into an extra 200 pounds on their frame, right? So, you know, I'm listening to Chuck. And, you know, we just started with nutrition counts. I said, let's sit down. Again, I'm assessing my client. You all are going to have, you know, a textbook assessment. The number one thing I'm going to tell you today, and some of the things that you're learning, I'll probably flip upside down in the real world. Sit down and listen to a person. Number one, they show up for the assessment. Sit down and just listen to someone. Listen to what they have to say. I might take that whole first hour and just listen and take notes and talk a little bit before telling anybody anything, depending on the situation. So Chuck and I start talking, take a listen to what he's doing. Of course, there's lots of soda, there's lots of fast food, there's go, go, go. There's a home caregiver business that takes up 7 days a week. They work 7 days a week around the clock, he and his wife do. So I said, let's start with the nutrition. So we open the book and I give him this list in front of you, which is the simple fat burn. These are my top nutritional picks, the top foods that I believe are probably the best things a person can eat. Now it changes a little bit person to person. Somebody says, hey, I can't do broccoli. Or hey, I'm allergic to onions. Or hey, I don't eat meat. But this is kind of a comprehensive list. So this list has been developed over the years. I could also add on here a protein shake. And again, you know, I kind of lean towards a vegan one. Again, healthy, whatever I think is organic and healthy. So I pulled this, bless you, I pulled this list out for Chuck, and he said, you know, I can eat a lot of these foods. So I configured his nutrition plan to start with protein every meal. He committed to coming in to see me once a week and filling out the food log. And after about a month and a half, we went out and started to do some exercise. And by that, I mean arm circles, you know, a leg lift, a calf raise. You know, you've got a person who's carrying an extra 200 pounds that hasn't exercised in 10 years. They're in really tough shape. And every week we do a little bit more progress. Or I will say the key concept here is going to be progression. You have to work a little bit more, a little bit harder, and a little bit differently in order to get results. Okay? You've got to keep changing the diet. You'll have that person like Chuck who was on all junk food. I said, Chuck, you're eating a lot of bread. A lot of bread. And I said, how about we cut the bread in half? A couple weeks later I came, I said, well, where's the bread? He said, oh, I just quit eating bread. And the weight came off, and it came off, and it came off. So here's the thing, the consciousness piece. You know, remember I said there's nutrition, there's exercise, and then there's what you think. Chuck kept writing down in his book accidentally that he was 100 pounds lighter than what he was. He would be at 312 and he'd accidentally write 212. He goes, gosh, I messed up again. I said, you know what, it's in your consciousness. And he looked at me one day and he said, it really is. So a big hunk of this thing called results comes from what we're thinking. And we forget, you know, the most powerful thing is what you're thinking. That's materializing everything in your life, both consciously and subconsciously. So, you know, Chuck's kind of the superstar. Now he comes in to see me for some training, you know, once a week. He's met his goal. And he'll said, oh, he's just coming to kind of hang in there. I said, no, he's going for his what next? What do you think the number one question is to someone who's lost 200 pounds? What do you think people ask him?
How'd
you do it? How fast? They ask him, do you have a lot of loose skin? I know, right? Maybe it's I think they do ask him, how did you do it? But they ask him, they ask me, does he have a lot of loose skin? And the answer is no. You know why? Again, it goes back to nutrition. There's a big difference from doing what I would call a starvation program, okay? I'll use a different term, Waste Watchers, hop on the scale and cut your calories, versus, you know, what I teach, which is, you know, eating organic foods. You probably have you talked at all about organic foods in this class? A little bit? No, not yet? Okay. So organic, you know, foods that don't have pesticides and herbicides, they're going to have a little green stamp. So the organic foods have quite a bit more vitamins and minerals compared to non-organic foods. You're not going to get organic foods out in a fast food place or even most restaurants. It'll say farm to table or organic, or when you go to the grocery store, it's going to be higher price. Absolutely. But vitamins and minerals and the nutrition end are why Chuck didn't have a lot of loose skin. When you fill the body with vitamins and minerals, fat burns in a nutrient-dense environment. So the better, higher quality food that you eat, absolutely, you're going to look vibrant. You're going to have energy. Did you ever see somebody who dropped 50 pounds real fast and they did it through starvation and they look kind of pale or kind of gray or kind of sallow and the skin is kind of hanging? That's not Chuck. Yes, he's got some loose skin. The man lost 200 pounds, but not a lot. And this was his attitude. He said, you know, I figured I'd give it a year and then just kind of see how I feel. Should I, have something done? I can tell you, he's not worried about the loose skin. He is just worried about running business, being the best person he can be, and really being healthy and fit. And he's got a whole new lease on life. He actually booked a motorcycle trip up in the Swiss Alps, was his gift to himself when he hit the 200-pound weight loss. He said, I'm not booking the trip until I hit the goal. So, you know, again, you've got to have it in your mind. All right, next guy. Did we cast around a little paper? I think we did, yes. Next one, this guy, case study. Tracy. So Tracy actually 88 pounds overweight. He worked out all the time. All the time. Dude was at the gym, Gold's Gym, went and went, talked to several trainers for several years. He was very overweight. He
he looked like the Michelin Man because he had muscle, but he looked like these puffy, round, big, heavy set guy. And he talked to me, I told him what I do, and he said, you know, I did the Weight Watchers program and it didn't work. This guy is so detailed. I think he works as an engineer because he's so detailed. He said, I did the program to a T, and you know, then they said, you're eating too much fruit. He said, but you said free fruits in the program. He didn't lose any weight. He lost like 2 pounds doing Weight Watchers. So I said, you know, here's the thing. Fruit is sugar. It's fructose. So, right, you're nodding. You know that piece of it. So if you're eating fructose and sugar, guess what? You're spiking your insulin and people won't lose weight because they're eating too much fruit or fruit without protein. So, you know, I taught him. I said, here's the thing. I think if we balance your nutrition and the weight starts to come off, you know, you're going to do really well. So he worked with me probably about a year. He loves the sports. So he's always, I'll pass these around just to take a good look at. So he goes to all the games. So he can take his sports weekends off and kind of party a little bit and have some food and drinks off the plan. And then he'd get back on. So it took him a little longer. He didn't sail through it like Chuck, who ate nothing off the plan and clean eating. But again, he had it in his mind. And here's the thing. A year later, he's maintained that weight loss. Still works out, probably still enjoys his sports on the weekends. And again, you know, you kind of go, wow, it's a process. That's another client here. This girl is a very successful graphic designer. And like you, she was a student just a few years ago. So she dropped about 30 pounds and she's not a thin girl. To look at her, she's, you know, still probably right around 190 pounds, but she's healthy. She works out 6 days a week. She feels good. She's, you know, she looks, there's a difference between being carrying some extra weight and being healthy and eating lots of healthy stuff and somebody who is just, it's wide open, they don't exercise. There's a different sort of confidence about her, but she's done really well. And Kristen's just, you know, she's just a really smart, sweet girl. Another case study I'll tell you about here. This is Leah. Now this is a quick transformation. Now, Leah's a very tall girl, and she did, I want to say, probably about 30 or 32 pounds in 2.5 months, keeping the food log. So, you know, I think that pictures kind of demonstrate how important nutrition is when it comes to transformation, and people are going to show up in your programs to transform, to get healthy, to get fit, to get lean. So, you know, what's the number one, number two killers and debilitators in the U.S. health-wise? Heart disease, number one. What's number two? Cancer. What else? Stroke. Right? So back when I first started in the fitness industry, I said, well, we got some big problems here. We've got mass epidemic problems with heart disease, cancer, and stroke. The number one thing that people can do to prevent these problems and get out of the woods if they're getting into a problem is nutrition. Yes, they should exercise. I mean, it's like, to me, it's like a three-legged chair. We've got nutrition, we've got exercise. And under exercise, you've got strength, right? And we've got cardio. Cardio is actually for your heart. Will it help lean you down? Absolutely. Will you have energy? Absolutely. So, you know, to me, this three-legged chair of your nutrition, your strength training, and your cardio, you know, if you take one of the legs away, the chair falls on the ground. So as you're assessing your people coming in and even looking at your own program, you know, are you working on your nutrition? Let me tell you what, everybody can stand and improve their nutrition, myself included. Are you really eating better quality foods? Are you getting lots of green vegetables? Are you actually, you know, plugging in the things that make a difference? So about 10 years ago, I had a client named Tom. He actually wasn't my client. I say client because loosely. So Tom was working out in the gym, and the other people in the gym said, Kathy, you gotta help this guy. He's doing this crazy workout, makes no sense. He's got this big belly, and he's there all the time. He's working really, really hard. So, you know, Tom and I had a couple conversations, and he was a smart guy, another engineer. And we had two lengthy conversations. By lengthy, I mean 20 or 30 minutes. and he sent me a couple messages. He sent me a couple emails, and he started tracking his food on MyFitnessPal. Has anyone here used MyFitnessPal? You're familiar with it, right? It's the number one app out there. So I said, Tom, forget the numbers on MyFitnessPal. They tell you to eat 200, 300 grams of carbohydrates. The calorie count is off for you. So I did the math for him, and since he was a numbers guy, he got the math. Tom lost 40 pounds. I never trained the man. Never trained him. Never cleaned up his workout routine that made no sense. So again, I am a personal trainer here telling you it is nutrition, nutrition, nutrition. This is the perfect topic for me to speak on today because I found myself as a personal trainer trying to help hundreds of people get in shape going back to coaching and counseling on nutrition. So again, heart disease. You're going to have people come in, they got all the bad tests from the doctor, and you all know someone who's diabetic or pre-diabetic, type 2, right? We eat our way there. Don't kid yourself. This is not something genetic, because now people are getting type 2 diabetes younger and younger. We have whole schools of children that are type 2 diabetic because of food, because we don't eat protein. We eat all processed and packaged foods. So back to Tom. So Tom lost 40 pounds, and that's when I decided to write the book. So you have in front of you the book, Simple Fat Burn, 3 Steps to Becoming Fit and Lean. And you know, the basics of it are you've got to control your carbohydrate intake. Everything works off the glycemic index. So how many of you are familiar with glycemic index? A few of you. Okay, so what the glycemic index is, I'm going to use this board over here. The glycemic index, and again, I kind of have my own version of it because I'll go on the internet and read things about glycemic index and they're dead wrong. They're dead wrong. So to me, the glycemic index 100. Okay? At the bottom, 0, we have protein. And we have fats. And then we start to creep up around 20, and we have green vegetables. You know, so everything, all of the foods that fall in here, 0 to 20. And this is going from low glycemic to high glycemic. Or somewhere around 50, maybe even 60, we have fruit, and maybe even higher. And then up at the top here, we have things like grain, and that's a biggie. People say, oh, eat your whole grains. Well, guess what? They're high glycemic, they spike insulin, start pulling the grain out of the diet, and guess what? People lose weight. The inflammation goes down. So grain would be at the top, and then up here we have all of the processed foods, right? So name some processed foods.
Doritos.
I love it. Who doesn't love Doritos? And we're going to talk a little bit about that. What else?
Cheetos.
We see where we're going here. Cheetos, chips, right? Cookies. That's my favorite. I'll tell you what, I live for a cookie or a cupcake, right? And here's the thing about what I teach. It's not that you can't have those things, but we cannot live up here and not experience inflammation in the body. Now back to the problems in society, the problem of heart disease and heart attacks. The number one cause of a heart attack is inflammation. 100% of the people that have a heart attack have inflammation. And where does that come from? Blood sugar, woof, up and down, okay? So your blood sugar should stay somewhere around 70 to 110 in this nice little mid-range. So when you have the omelet, the veggie omelet, the grilled chicken salad, the maybe steak and green vegetables, maybe you have a vegan protein shake. Up here, when you eat the high glycemic foods, your blood sugar is going to 200, 300, 400. I've heard of diabetics ending up in the ER, teenagers being tested, blood sugar 700. Wow. Guess what? McDonald's. Big old meal of fast food, type 2 diabetic, you're in the hospital. So the way we become a type 2 diabetic is we keep eating lots of processed foods, and it all boils down to one thing, carbohydrate consumption. So the question is, how many grams of carbohydrates does a person consume versus the other things? Protein, fat. So there's a formula that I came up with.
And this formula is very, very simple. On the list that you have, the protein list, we didn't get a list. Okay, let's make sure we get it. So the protein list is going to be the first column. That protein list, you need a whole, whether you're a vegan, a vegetarian, yep, and whether you're a vegan, vegetarian, you eat meat or you don't eat meat, you got one. Oh, over here this way, one, two, I'll come back over here. All right, I want you to really look at that protein list because that is the base of every meal that will actually burn fat and balance your blood sugar. I'll pass back a couple more here. And, yep. All right, I think everybody's got a sheet here. So that protein list, this is the base of every meal to balance blood sugar. Eggs, meat, fish, chicken, turkey, tofu, edamame, and you could add your protein shake. I'm not a big fan of protein bars. Not a big fan. They're processed. Most of them are full of sugar. They're just not the healthiest thing. But if you have that instead of candy bar, I have one little saying, better is better, right? If I grabbed a protein bar instead of a candy bar, I think I'm ahead of the game a little bit, depending on the nature of that protein bar. Some of them are full of sugar. Some of them are pretty low glycemic. And again, I might have a student come into me who's been living on donuts and cookies and chips and Doritos and is 50 pounds overweight, and I'm like, hey, let's just start with Quest Bar. Let's start there. Better is better. Let's have a protein shake. I don't really care what kind. So, you know, you're assessing people, and I'm always going back to balancing blood sugar to burn body fat, to reduce inflammation. And again, you know, we could work out all day long. You can work out 7 days a week, but if you don't work out the nutrition, you're not going to see results in progress physiologically. A person might feel a little bit better. They might actually feel worse. So think about it. If you're loading the body with toxic food and you go get a hard workout and you've got inflammation, you're not going to feel good. You're going to feel like crap. It's so horrible, as a matter of fact. Those workouts are going to get harder and harder. Instead of the person turning the corner going, wow, I've got proper nutrition. I've got fuel to exercise. So I think nutrition, I don't care what area of the field you're going into, is critical to have an understanding of nutrition. And then you may be the person who's hiring someone. Find out, can you teach someone how to balance their blood sugar? Can you teach someone and counsel someone and coach someone to make improvements in nutrition? I'm trained as a social worker. You know, I'm trained to help people transform no matter what the platform is to become a better version of their former self. So, and we use all kinds of tools. You know, it's like if someone had to get across the town, just pull out the map. You know, the same thing. So one person might be a MyFitnessPal. Another person might, you know, want to get into a food log and actually write. I really like the process of writing it down. I think you've got something that you can track. I also came up with recipes that actually burn fat. Okay? So, the book Simple Fat Burn, I was saying I was at Amazon yesterday, and the book sells all day long on Amazon. So, you know, I'm always amazed at how many people buy this book, get results straight out of the book, and then they buy copies for friends and family members and highlight areas and say, this is the single most comprehensive way for a person to learn the basics and take some steps. So, talking about the consciousness piece, page 102, I want you to turn to, is my favorite page in this book, page 102. And this is not just for burning fat and eating better. This is kind of for life. This is the I am statement page where you actually write the new story. So all of these people that I'm talking to you about, they wrote a new story with their nutrition and fitness and got real change. The sad part is most people show up and they join a gym or a fitness center or a program and they don't get change. Why? Maybe it's in their consciousness. Maybe their belief system really doesn't believe they can do it. So this is neat because this page actually is where people go in and they write the new story. I am fit. I am healthy. I am cured. I am healed. I am 150 pounds. Whatever it is, you have to start somewhere with changing that belief system. So I found it to be incredibly useful to just get someone to talk and change their belief system. You know, Chuck believed he was going to be healthy. He believed he was going to lose 200 pounds, both consciously and subconsciously. So, questions? Yes.
Yeah. When your glycemic index, when it's too high, what exactly does it do to your body?
Great question. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So there's a great little video by Dr. Westman where he takes, he says, your bloodstream can handle 1 teaspoon of glucose at a time. Okay? So what it does is your insulin rises very fast. That's exactly what happens. Insulin goes up and the brain gets the message, keep eating. So it won't be one slice of pizza, it'll be four. So keep eating, keep on the high glycemic foods. And the bloodstream gets flooded with insulin, the blood sugar goes up, and bam, your body fat percentage goes up. That's what happens. Your inflammation, whatever those weak areas in your body, let's say you've got back issues, let's say you've got problems with your feet, those inflammatory, you know, they're like little electric shocks will go off. You'll have pain, you'll be tired, your blood sugar will go high, then it'll drop low. That's that big curve, though. It goes high, then it kind of spikes down. So let's say, you used to see this in offices all the time. They send in the box lunch, right? It's the chips, the cookie, and the sandwich, and we have lunch. By 2 o'clock, everybody's eyes are closing. Blood sugar spiked up and dropped down, right? We don't feed people a grilled chicken salad in massive production. We feed them cookie, chips. So we've got 250 grams of carbohydrates that are high glycemic. And then someone sitting next to me who's a fitness professional will say, I was only going to eat half the cookie, but I ate the whole thing. The insulin. Okay? So blood sugar up, blood sugar down. They get tired in the afternoon. They crash. I know for me, I used to struggle with sugar, and I really mastered that by using the system of eating protein and fiber. I would always be like, oh man, I gotta go get a Blizzard. And that would be out cold on the couch, right? Go get a Blizzard about 1 o'clock, right? Even the small one. The baby one has 45 grams of sugar, and it's corn syrup, right? So all carbohydrates are created differently, and this is an area that you need to study. You know, there's a big difference between a green bean and a Blizzard. They're both carbohydrates, right? It's like, which carbs are the good carbs? You know, the good carbs are the green ones and the yellow ones and the ones that come from organic vegetables. Your body is made to take in three things, vegetables, protein, and water, right? That's really what the human body is made to take in. Man made up the rest of this and said, Cheetos and Doritos are an awesome idea. And then that food is made in a chemistry lab. And what happens, the best chefs in the world, they go mimic the best flavors and come up with cheese. I was watching this on 60 Minutes one day. And, you know, they come up with these flavors in a lab and they create a cheese experience. And I'm eating some Cheetos at the time. And it's like cheese steroids going off. I'm like, wow, I get it. So that you come back and you have an experience again and again and again. And the brain and the body has this memory that says, man, I gotta have Cheetos today. And then tomorrow I gotta have Cheetos. And we get hooked on the same food. Chemicals like MSG are bring you back again. And then people have some very, very serious reactions when you keep loading the body with toxins. So again, vegetables, protein, and water, the things that you're gonna find on this list, this is what a person is supposed to be eating. You know, we think, you know, oh, is it this product? Is it that product? You know, it's not one thing that gets a person better over time. It's cleaning up the nutrition, cleaning up the mindset, learning about what's working, paying attention to how you feel and what's working and not working. So, all right. So, other things that I want to go over with you in the book. Insulin and blood sugar, chapter 8, page 39. All right, this is the hub of nutrition. If there's any one thing I want you to learn today, is that energy comes from vitamins and minerals, organic foods when possible, and balanced blood sugar. By balanced blood sugar, I mean protein is the base, paired with carbohydrates that are low glycemic, paired with healthy fat, things like avocado, things like coconut, things like olive oil. And again, it's a formula. It's a formula to balance blood sugar. Now you could eat foods that aren't organic and still balance your blood sugar. You could go out and order, if I went to Chick-fil-A, order a grilled chicken salad, right? And it's healthy. Dressing on the side, maybe something light. But here's what I want you to remember, everything matters. Every little thing you put in your body matters. Every little thing that your client or your associate or your friend, they're going to say, oh gosh, I got a migraine headache.
you know, I don't keep Advil in the house. Maybe I need to think about what I had to eat and drink. You know, if I got a headache, right? A headache's a natural occurrence. There's always a cause and effect in the body. Yes?
What's TVP?
TVP, that is textured vegetable protein. So you're going to have people show up who are vegans and say, I'm not eating an egg. I'm not eating meat. Any vegans in the room here? One? Yeah, absolutely. And that's okay. You know, there's nothing we can't work with. You know, this list is most of us eat meat, fish, eggs, but if you don't eat that, absolutely, you still balance your blood sugar by getting in tofu, edamame, a vegan protein shake. Absolutely. Work with vegans. And here's the thing. Most people, when they slow down and really look at their nutrition, they go, wow, I feel better when I put these healthy foods in and these quality foods in and stop eating so much processed food. We all love it. Yes.
Is turkey bacon good?
Is turkey bacon good? So, let's think about that for a moment. Turkey bacon. It's a good question because people say, well, is it better than full fat bacon? I'll tell you, if I were going to have a slice of bacon, I would get something organic, meaning Applegate bacon. You can buy it at Kroger. And again, bacon typically is full of nitrates and hormones. And when we look at the source of pork products, and again, I eat some pork, but I would say organic, real bacon. Fat is not the enemy. You need healthy fat. Your brain power works off fat. People always ask me, what you do, is it paleo? I said, no, it's not paleo. You know, is it this, is it that? It's a mix of, I've looked at all of the nutrition programs out there, and it's what works best for the person in front of me. Yes. Question.
All right, so I try to eat organic, and like I try to tell my friends to eat organic, but they always give me the argument, how is it better? Like, it's cheaper to eat this apple that's like 89 cents a pound versus organic,
right,
which is 139 a pound.
I love this question. Okay, so you're right. Is cheaper always better?
No, I don't think so.
It's not. So that's what I would answer them with a question, is cheaper better? And, but here's why we want to eat organic. So remember when I said that the food was made in a lab to taste good, and they're going to come up with this concoction. So our food that is not organic, most of it is produced by, behind it, the seed is coming from a company called Monsanto. Who's familiar with Monsanto? Okay. So they own most of the seed that is produced, so it's genetically modified. So I started paying attention to this maybe about 4 years ago, and I've been in the business 20 years. But what I would notice, I'd go to get a lemon, and that lemon would be big and round, and I'd slice it open, and there were no seeds in it. But it didn't taste real lemony, okay? That's a genetically modified lemon. So here's what I want you to know. If it's not organic, the pesticide is in the seed. This is a big deal. The pesticide, there will never be a bug in all of those rows of corn. There's never going to be one bug because it's Roundup. So when you're not eating organic, you are eating Roundup in every single meal. And I hate to say this, but the cancer centers are full. From the little babies to the seniors, the cancer centers are full. It is coming from our food supply. That is why we need to eat organic. Because the food supply, to some degree, is toxic. Now, the body can detoxify. You know, the body can detoxify. But what we're